for you guys, for those of you who aren't too savvy as far as the North American scene is concerned, it's going to be Hiko, Kusta, Simple, Elysian, Nitro on the CT side for Liquid, as they did win the pistol or the knife round. And then for Winter Fox, we're going to have Lex, XP3, Flowsick, Desi, and Anger. And the last time that we actually saw Winter Fox play, at least in Pro League, they split a series and took a big map win on Mirage not too terribly long ago. So Anger really stepped up, XP3 in that matchup as well. So we'll have to see how this one pans out, but it looks like relatively standard stuff coming out from the Winter Fox side to start things off, as well as the Liquid side. So you can see Elysia's going to set up for a pop flash in front of Big Red over here in the A-bomb site. And they've also gone for a double boost here from Winter Fox and maybe a split towards the B-bomb site. As you see, the bomb is actually working its way around towards the backside of Checkers. So actually going in and reverse boosting to get mid control. And this is something that I've seen a couple of times recently as far as strategy concerned on the terrorist side, is taking over checker control, boosting up into the vents, and then taking over mid control from there. But XP3 finds the first frag. Simple does manage to trade back, at least takes down Flowsick, but now they've still got two players to deal with over here in this bomb site at A, and they are going to be able to clean that out. Lex does find two back-to-back headshots and makes it a 3v2. So Hiko and Simple on the retake, and Simple actually does spot out one in that smoke, not able to connect just yet, and trying to do a little bit of damage here, but they get away, Winter Fox, and now they've got decent post-plant positions, one by Forklift, one in sight, and one at Quad. Now the push comes on around. Simple goes down. Last man standing is going to be Hiko. Hits a nice headshot onto one, but he's going to get double peaked here and surely going to go down in a second. And somehow he's still alive, trying to make this happen. 1v1. Anger does manage to clean him up. So a little sloppy there at the end, but Winter Fox get it done and take it 1-0 for the pistol round.
Yeah, that was a really good round by Winter Fox. They got B control, went into checkers. Simple actually had a really good peek to get some information to see that they were boosting back up an event. So I'm sure that call was made. It looked like Elige got a little caught out. It was as they were coming up highway, but Lex made two good shots, was able to take the site, and had a good plan.
So now we see a little bit of a force up from the Liquid side. They're going to put armor and pistol on three of their members, upgrade to a P250 for Elige, and maybe go for a pop flash into A main. But Elige actually just dry peeks it, so they're going to know that nobody's over here, and they're filtering all the way back towards B. And this is the right call from Liquid. They're going to have a very stark defense over here at this B bomb site, as you can see some of the nades raining in through the window. And now the push is going to come in here from Winter Fox. Flowsick does open up, but they've got so much more presence over here to deal with. Anger and Lex chime in. And now it's going to be down to these last two players to hold off. And Hiko does manage to find one, but Kusta can't get anything out of that. And Winter Fox are going to clean up. So the stack ends up not working out here for Liquid.
Yeah, it's a pretty standard play by Winter Fox. A lot of teams like to go B. And the faster you go, the more information you get. It was a good play by Liquid to get that peek into A main to see there was nothing there, but they weren't able to rotate over to B quick enough. If Simple was able to do anything in that corner, maybe something would happen, but they took over the site too quick.
Yeah, so now we're going to see that little bit more of a limited buy. Simple does buy up a 5-7 and armor, so he's actually going to be at $950 going into the next round, which is kind of a curious decision to make. And they're going to go for the heavy play over at the B-bomb site this time around for the Liquid side. Just leave Nitro over here to spot out some mid-presence. They haven't boosted anybody up top. They are going to molly out at the back of B just to try to clear out anybody that's over there at headshot, but they're not going to push behind that. So Winter Fox taking this one very, very slowly.
Yeah, he's completely open right now too, so if they get this information, they'll be able to take it.
I was going to say, now they smoke out over towards the A-bomb site, and the rotation is going to be on from Liquid. The push is going to come in, and now they're going to spot that the stack was over at B, so they're going to have no problem getting in, getting the bomb plant. And they actually, Lex did go for a default plant, but then decided to plant it for A main, so it's going to be a very difficult retake here for Liquid. See if they even do decide to go for this. They're going to start filtering out here into middle, looking for that flanker to come around from the backstab in mid. And XP3, he's just biding his time. But Desi opens up, finds Nitro. A couple more players filtering in towards this A bomb site to try to do a little bit of economical damage. But Kusta should get spotted here going up top, and he does. And now XP3 coming on the flank. Finds one, finds two. Finally, Simple's going to be able to pounce and take him down. But Kusta, again, up there on top of the ladder, is going to fall to Lex. And not a whole lot of damage being dealt here from Liquid side.
Yeah, I really like what Winter Fox did there. And for any younger teams out there, it's just a really smart play. For one eco, you go quickly, you try to pressure, see if there's anything there. And then the second eco, you do more of a standard default. Try to bait out some maybe pop flashes, try to get some information. And that's exactly what they did. They had two people over at B, three holding A, and then they got the information at A and took it.
So now you can actually see Simple's going to be on a Mag 7 into this round. So that force up into that third round was very curious to me. Kusta's going to be on a naked op, no body armor or head armor to speak of, very limited utility for Liquid. Oh, XP wow. 3, nice shot, takes Hiko off the map. And now it's going to be Simple to try to hold things down over a beep with just a Mag 7. Swaps out for the M4, that's a smart play. And then we'll see if he's going to be able to do any damage, but he's going to actually aggress behind this smoke. So this is kind of a risque position to put themselves in. He's pushing all the way through on this. Blow stick right around the corner. And there you go. He's going to get spotted, but now the jig is up and he just fully pushes. Why not? Evens it back up, but XP3 is lined up and ready for this. So very slow, strange start to this map. There you go. Now they're going to flank around. Somehow Simple spins and takes down Anger. So he gets the 2-for-2 over at the B-bomb site. But Desi's going to open back up, takes down a Liege. And now it's going to be a 3-on-2, kind of a retake situation. Now is that bomb going to work in towards that B-bomb site? But two of the players from Winterfox very, very low here. XP3 at 12, Desi at 28. They're finally going to make their way into the bomb site. Both of the CTs are over here. Kusta with the AWP up in heaven. But again, no bomb plant just yet. Finally, it goes down, but are they going to decide to save here? Looks like they're backing away.
Yeah, it looks like it, and I think it's a good play. They don't actually, I mean, not knowing how low Winterfox is, XP3 and Desi, they can't really make a good play on this. The bomb's planted in the right spot for Winterfox. It'd be a tough retake for Liquid, and it's based off of the force buys they had in the previous rounds. That was actually a pretty incredible round. XP3's pick on Hiko was through the smoke. And if you actually ever watch Liquid, Hiko usually plays B by himself. Simple's the rotator. Hiko loves to spam through the smoke. So I think XP3 just took the shot and was able to hit him. And then Simple made a really good play after that, knowing that he needed to make a play, get some information. He pushed through the smoke, got 2 kills, but they weren't able to capitalize on it.
So now we see Winterfox up 4-0 right now. Liquid are going to carry 2 rifles into the next round. They've got the AWP, and they're actually going to drop a couple of FAMASes here. So this is a force up if I've ever seen one. And we're going to see if they're going to be able to stem the bleeding a little bit here and not let Winterfox take out complete control on the T side. You kind of said it in pregame, or at least you prefaced it a little bit, where if you get the knife round and you decide to start on CT, you're banking on having a strong CT half on the back of that. And right now, Liquid's come out flat-footed.
Yeah, and the unfortunate thing about that is when it's going like it is for Liquid, then it kind of can start spiraling out of control. If they don't pick up this round, they're going to have to save. They're going to be down 5, possibly 6, and you really are going to have to regroup and talk about what's going on, you know, to start getting some rounds on CT, because this is looking pretty bad.
Yeah, definitely not the start that they want. They do have a decent buy behind this. Kusta, again, without any armor on the AWP, but he's playing this kind of aggressive position over here by A main. So if they decide to push in on Winterfox's side, he's should have an opportunity to at least take a shot and fall back, or at least take cover behind Big Red in that A bomb site. But it does look like Winterfox is going to gear up for this A take. This stream of smokes is going to come out over the top of the wall, and they should be hightailing it in through A main, and that's exactly what they're going to do. So the pressure is on Kusta now, and he's actually going to fall back behind the smoke, so he's going to have no line of sight on this. It's going to end up having to be a 5-on-5 retake situation. Nitro trying to find something. They do manage to find a little bit of a wall bang there on the Desi. Takes him down to 64, but up on top of Big Red, they find that opening pick. Nitro pushing forward through the smoke to the back of Forklift is able to find one, but he gets traded instantly. Elise is there, so it's back and forth right now. Oh no, and Hiko actually just threw a little team damage onto one player, and I think he might have walled Simple all the way through the back garage in towards A main too, so that's a little bit of a mistake there. But again, 3-on-3 retake, all three players over here by quad, so this is kind of a tough spot, but now they know, and now they're going to be able to clean things up. So there you go, much needed round for Liquid.
That was actually a big play. It was a 3v3. They were really patient because they knew Simple was coming through Squeaky, and coming through, you know, the T's are not going to be expecting that. He was able to come out the door, get the guy that was head stacked, probably should have had a second kill, but they were able to push at that moment and pick up the other 2 kills to defuse the bomb. It was kind of fortunate because Kusta, who you mentioned didn't have armor, he did that jump peek. They were able to kill him through the smoke because he immediately got aim punched and couldn't get away, and it was just an easy kill, but really good job by Liquid.
Yeah, and adversely, I mean, you talk about the kind of strategy that they had there. They pushed so aggressively on that retake, getting in front of those smokes, that it never allowed Winterfox to get really good post-plant positions. That's why you saw all three of them huddled up over there by quad. Now, they have an element of surprise with that they're not going to expect that many bodies to all be in the same spot, but it also ends up being a double-edged sword where, you know, they're clustered up, So it's going to make spraying them down really easy, and that ended up being the case at the end of that round. But nevertheless, finally, Liquid able to get on the board. It's 4-1. They've got a big mid presence here. It looks like, actually, yeah, they are mollied out of the vents, but they're going to boost Simple up in here. So they might not necessarily be prepared for a player to be up in vents having just mollied that out, but we'll have to see how they adapt to this. The smokes go out over mid. Anger's going to be leading the charge, and he's going to come around the corner. It's Simple's time to pounce. And there you go. Elige finds the opener. Simple's going to go ahead and back off, but he's at least got the information that Anger is out mid, and Elige is going to be able to clean him up. So a much cleaner beginning to this round for Liquid's side. Push comes in towards B. Flow sick. There it is. The push from Simple through the smoke. Not going to even allow him to sniff the bomb site, and he takes them both down with the trade from Hiko. So two rounds in a row now for Liquid, and they do it with only one player dropping at the end, so that's going to help their money situation.
Yeah, I really like that round by Simple. He recognized that he wasn't able to get an easy kill out mid. He fell out of vents quickly and didn't sacrifice himself. He actually fell all the way back into spawn. Hiko was the one that engaged, and then he was able to come into the site and get two quick kills and made that round really easy. If he had died in vents or falling out of the vents, that round could have been totally different for Winterfox.
That's one of the things that I've actually talked about before. With that molly that you can throw over the top of the mid roof and try to flush the player out of the vents, having an AWP on the other side of that over by Useless or Toxic Room to try to pick that player off when he falls out of the vents to avoid the damage is something that we've been seeing more and more. But
Tempo Storm actually does that the best, where I'm pretty sure they've taken it from LG, where they literally molly out all of checkers and vent and make it impossible for the guy to get out of vent. But you're right, it's a smart play to do that.
Yeah, throw one flashbang and the guy just roasts alive. So this time around, though, it's going to be a save from Winterfox. They do invest in 5 Desert Eagles, and we know that these guys have been able to make the Deagles work in the past. We'll see how they're going to be able to adapt to that going into this round, as it's going to be both Kusta at quad watching towards mid. Now he's going to change his direction up, looking towards A main. He finds the opening pick, but they're not going to account for Nitro to be over here. He's going to line him up, knock him down, finds 2 kills. That's Lex and Flosick and the bomb. Now Simple, and finally Nitro again, and that will be a very clean, very quick round for Liquid.
That's a great setup. Kusta's in quad. He gets the first pick. They're not expecting Nitro to be at fence, and he just cleans up 3 quick kills. So really nice round.
And I like that kind of strategy, too. Leave one over by NBK on the fence and play a little beat and switch, you know.
Yeah.
There's a guy over by quad with the AWP. You're not really going to expect a guy to be at the fence.
A lot of teams, just as soon as that AWP takes that first shot, what do you want to do? You want to charge him and try to get take the AWP away from him, get that kill, and it just leaves Nitro to get those free kills.
So now we see another buy-up from Winterfox. They've got decent utility behind this. Look at how many Molotovs as well. 3 of them have all got smokes. Everybody's got at least one flash to work with, and it looks like it's going to be another one of those A executions. And again, Nitro playing over here by the quad NBK wall. He sees the smoke come out. He's going to fall back behind quad. And he's just going to bide his time. He's actually got a Molly Prime to throw in front of the squeaky door in case that's where the push is going to come. But now look at this. Winterfox revamping their strategy. They're going to work back over towards B. And the rotation has kind of been pulled a little bit here from the Liquid side. They have lurked Anger out into the site, and they have no idea. He pushes through the smoke. He finds the first frag. He does get flashed out, but he's still alive in the site, so he's just going to be a nuisance. Finds a second kill. Finally, Nitro shuts him down, but the bomb is on B, and now they've got an open site to work with. Only Kusta here to defend. No smoke goes down, but they don't need it because the bomb is already worked in. At least Nitro's going to make a bid to make this a little bit more even. Finds a second kill, but he's only on 12 HP. So this is going to be a very, very trepidatious retake here from the CT side, and that's a good molly in towards A main, and now they might just save, and that's exactly what they're going to do. So they're going to fall back and hang on to the AK and the AWP for the next round.
Yeah, it's a smart play. Even though their money's looking pretty good, they're just not in a situation to retake the site. And I really love that play by Winterfox. A lot of teams, it's really a risky play. They did a full execute towards A, and they lurked 2 people out into the site. Anger was able to pick up 2 kills and really sold the fake hard. Liquid had rotated 3 players over, but they kind of started recognizing that it was a fake. Hiko was caught out of place over at B and was easily picked, and Anger was able to get 2 kills in A. So you're just caught in no man's land. Kusta didn't know where to go. You have no idea if they're hitting A or B, and it was just a beautiful round by them.
Well executed indeed, and that gives Winterfox their 5th round. So coming into the 9th round, it's 5-3. It's going to be another buy here for Liquid. Those 3 rounds that they got in a row did help their economy enough, and now they're going to go straight into a double AWP setup. So Simple's going to have one. Kusta's going to have one. And Simple looking for the quick peek over towards B, but it's not going to come. And now it looks like they might go for a boost strat. He goes up on top of the boxes, just staring down at Simple. Maybe they wanted to go for the boost up into useless room to try to get an early pick. But this time around, it looks like it's just going to be a straight hit towards the A bomb site. But again, they kind of lined up for this last round and went for that fake back towards the B bomb site. So we'll see what they decide to do here in a second as the smokes rain on in. Hot Flash comes out from Nitro. He's going to have a line of sight here. Molly and Smoke go out in towards A main, so that's going to hold Anger back from being able to push forward and try to get that early pick in towards the A bomb site. And again, they go back and boost a couple of players to execute mid control from the Winter Fox side. So they've got a pretty good spread, and Anger actually just comes out A main and wrecks Nitro. Simple does get the trade, but it's a split back towards B. Now, this time around, they've got Kusta and Hiko over here, and they're going to hear those vents get broken. XP3 with a cheeky little shoulder peek. Going to be able to get away. And Kusta actually missing a second shot. He's going to have one more opportunity, but it's Simple actually coming around from Heaven's side that finds Flowsick. They still haven't gotten sight control. And they have no smokes for A main, or B main, pardon me. So this is going to be really tricky. Almost lines him up. There you go. Elise comes in. Simple gets a second one. It's down to a 1v1. But Desi on 34 HP. 30 seconds left. Bomb is dropped towards B main. So this is going to be a really tricky situation for Desi to try to pull out. But he does pick up an AWP, so he's at least got a one and done gun here.
Yeah, this will be interesting. Liege is in a good spot. It's kind of it's on the box. It's a little bit different angle. Blinded and pushed off. We'll see. Wow. Both of them on 12 HP.
Yeah, bomb does go down, so they get the money in the bank. Desi looking for the peak now. He's jumped up inside of the site, and he's going to take a nice line of sight. This is perfect. Desi should be able to... Oh, I was going to say should be able to lock this one down, but... Elise gets out behind it and does find him through the smoke. So,
got him through the smoke.
Yeah, a little bit of an awkward end to that round. Comes down to the 1v1. Liquid going to come out on top, put a fourth round on the board. But the big thing about it is that they have four rebuys that they need after that round is all said and done. Granted, they get the win. They've got a decent amount of money, but they're going to drain the bank going into this next round. So if Winter Fox can actually pick up the next one, it could force a save here for Liquid.
Yeah, I'm glad seeing Liquid pick up the round. It looked like it was in their favor when you saw the three Winter Fox players did not have a smoke to cross into the site. You had Kusta watching the cross. You had Simple on top of him. It looked like it was going to be shut down. I'm really surprised that even came down to a one-on-one. Oh, wow.
There you go, though. Simple doing simple things. Finds the opening, too. He's still over here by Checkers. He is going to finally get taken down. The smoke from the nade is going to block his field of vision just long enough for that trade to finally come out. But it's a 2-for-1 to favor Liquid to start things off, and they've already rotated Elise over. So Hiko, really the last line of defense in the back of this B-bomb site, but he's going to peek out, finds the headshot on Lex, and that's going to be Anger and Desi. They've got an AWP and an AK to work with, but that Molly is going to be good, but not good enough. Hiko peeks out, takes off Anger's head, and now it's down to Desi in a 1v3. We'll see if he's going to be able to manage this one. The 1v1 didn't work out, so why not do a 1v3? Elise has got a good line of sight, though. He's up there in heaven just waiting for the cross to come out. Desi poking his head out, and he's going to get decapitated. So tied up 5-5, back into the double-op setup goes Liquid, and we will be seeing them pick up pick up another round, so they at least tie it out.
The setup for Liquid on CT side is just strong. Where do you go? You have Kusta over in A, holding it with an AWP. You have Simple over in B, who's going to play aggressive with that AWP. You saw there, he got Winter Fox challenged him. He gets two early picks. Then you have to deal with Hiko in the site, who, you know, his history has proven that he shuts down anything in B. He's a very good solo site player, but when you have Simple there getting the early picks, it's just going to make that much easier for him.
So this time around, it will be another save from Winter Fox, and the nades doing the damage, softening them up. XP3 is going to be at 23, Flowsick at 16, and there you go. Kusta spots the bomb, actually, and takes him down. And now, oh, the pressure coming out. Desi jumping around the corner, kind of gave up his position a little bit early, and Elise with the shutdown. Kusta picks up a pair, Elise picks up the triple, and that will be Liquid finally taking their first lead of the matchup at 6-5.
Yeah, just an easy cleanup eco for Liquid. Kusta picking mid, getting the early information, and Elige playing highway just cleans up the rest.
It's a little bit dicey with Lex leading with the bomb out mid, too, because they got bomb control really, really early in the round on Liquid's side. So there was no real juke to the strat. There was no real thought process going into that, except we're going to try to
plant. Yeah, I think they just wanted to take some guns away. That was the best they were going to get out of it. That wasn't really a play to try to plant the bomb. If they got lucky to plant the bomb, then they do. But it's a highway push, and really, you're only going to be able to plan on highway side. If you're going to be running into Elise and Nitro, you're going to have to get some just lucky headshots when you're running around.
This time around, it looks like a very similar strat to what we just saw in the last round. They went for the early boost there, and they've gotten mollied off a boost twice, and the nades again have rained over the top of that mid-garage and found a little bit of damage. XP3 on 77, 76 for Desi, and 64 for Anger. So the nades doing their damage, softening them up a little bit to start the rounds out. And Kusta, he's actually by the toxic barrels by A main. So if they push in, he's going to get that early intel again going into this round. But doesn't look like he's really going to get tested by A main because they've got three players up on boost right now for Winter Fox.
Yeah, and he's already given them the information they need. Look where they're playing. They have Liquid has two in mid, and they have two basically towards B because Kusta's given them all the information they're not in A main.
So there you go. The opening trade at least goes out. We're going to see Desi fall. Almost a double kill there from Alish as he does take Anger down to 18. And now they know the jig is up. Now they know that they've come out towards mid side, and they're going to be able to collapse. Now you got two players over at B, two players over at A. Anger actually coming in through the Z hallway, but he's going to get shut down. Pico's going to be able to find the opening pick, not able to transfer the spray, but now coming around for the backstab is going to be Nitro, and he's going to be able to take down Flowsick. But in the meantime, Simple actually went down at B, so it's on Kusta and Nitro to try to retake this one. And we'll see if they're going to be able to do just that here in a second. XP3 by B main. He's going to get smoked out of position, so he's going to have to revamp his strategy and work back over towards Checkered side. Throws some spam, actually pulls the distraction on Nitro, and Kusta not lining up the off shots. He's going to get flanked out, and beautifully played 2v2 from Winter Fox.
That was really good. That was actually a really interesting strat that I have not seen many people try to pull off. They take over mid, and Liquid had by that point had already fallen back into the sites. Hiko was rotating back to B, and they give the presence at highway by jumping across. Nitro sees them, but instead of going highway, they have a smoke that lands at CT spawn to block off truck, and they push through the Z connector, catch Hiko off guard. Simple gets picked, and it's an easy B side take with no one able to get any trades because there's a smoke blocking truck. Really, really good play that I have not seen that often from any of these teams.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever actually seen that smoke play. I was wondering because they lined it up when they were up on top of the mid boost, and they threw it. I don't know if our cameraman can go back over towards boost side and look towards Z. But they threw it out like between the little bit of scaffolding, the girders that are up there, up over the top of the roof, and it lands all the way in that valley right behind truck. So really, really cool stuff. Desi, though, opening up, takes down Simple. So that's one gun off the map already in this round for Winter Fox. And there's still a minute and 10 left to play. So the early aggression, again, I mean, that's just going to be, I mean, where did he die? He died over there by E-Box. Or actually, was he up on Heaven? No, he was by E-Box. So
yeah, he was on E-Box. Desi had a really great shot out of door. Opened it up and insta headshot Simple.
Nicely done. So there you go.
Anger lurking out there again. I guess he's been doing a really good job getting at least one kill on these lurks. We'll see how he does.
Yo, this is going to be scary. Now they know that he's there. Kusta does find Lex, so the misfire there from Anger is going to be his demise in the long run. So he ends up going down, and now it's all down to Desi again, 1v4, and should be absolutely impossible for him to clutch this one out.
Yeah, it was also, I talked about earlier how Hiko plays the B side alone. Let's see what happens here. Bird. Desi's going to run into Hiko.
Well, he's got to get past the leash, and he does that. Hiko actually dropping that smoke out, so he's giving himself cover to play back in the back of the bomb site. And Desi's got to know that he's here. I mean, this is just should be an unclutchable situation, and there you go. Hiko just sitting stalwart in the back of the bombsite saying, come at me, bro.
Yeah.
And Nitro's just going to flank him out.
I'm guessing Desi was just trying to take some guns away. I don't know if he knew he knew Hiko was there when the smoke went down, so he didn't want to die after the round had ended to not get any money, but it was an interesting play because the bomb was down in mid, so he was never actually going for the round win unless he just kills everyone. But Liquid on the last round, they actually left Hiko by himself and played everyone towards A.
Oh man, Simple. He might get caught out here. He's in such an awkward spot. He spots the rush though, so he knows that they're coming B. The nades have softened them up once again. It's going to be a spray down. Hiko with two. Looking for a third. He's going to get it. And Simple and Alish clean up the last two. So in a flash, the round is over. But that could have gotten really scary for Liquid because Simple took a really wide peek over there by B main and spotted a lot of bodies.
Yeah, he had the good spawn. He dropped down, so got the information that they were rushing, and it should have been a call by it would be an easy call to say this is an eco after basically a full reset, and you know, just be ready. Eco was ready. They got in good positions and cleaned up the kills.
It should kind of be said right now, 4-6 for Kusta, not really the performance that we're used to seeing out of the young gun, but again, not really getting too terribly pressured in a lot of the situations, as he only has six deaths in the opening 14 rounds. So final round of the half, it's going to be a Tech 9 for Flowsick. He's actually already down. Simple finds that opening kill. Molly comes out towards Vince. Hiko's going to take one with him to the grave, and that's going to be Desi getting the trade, but dropping immediately afterwards. And now it's Simple and Elige over here by B to try to lock this one down. And look at Nitro. Hi, guys. I'm just going to flank you out. Med takes down Anger and Lex. 9-6 going to be the halftime score. Liquid kind of bring it back. They were down 5-0 at one point, or 4-0 at least.
Yeah, we talked about in that 4-0 round how big of a round that was going to be, because it could easily be 6-0 after that round. They were on FAMAS. They had the op by Kusta, which had no armor, and that was a big round. They won that round and actually turned it around. I think the biggest change was they went to a double op setup during those mid rounds, and it really gave them a lot of information. You had Simple peeking into B main, was getting those early two picks. You had Kusta up on the toxic barrels peeking into A main, and even though there was no one there, it gives Liquid all the information in the world of what's going on. So I think that's how Liquid wants to play now. Simple can play with the rifle and an op at any given time, and on this map for CT side, having two ops is giving you so much information. It allows you to make rotates you wouldn't normally make.
So let's see how they adapt to the terrorist side now, talking about Liquid, and see if Winter Fox can win the second half pistol. Now, that's kind of the interesting thing, is that Winter Fox did win the pistol in the first half and ended up getting six rounds on the T side, which is kind of curious because they did execute the anti-ecos relatively cleanly as well. So three out of their six rounds came on the pistol and the two anti-ecos. They were only able to win three gun rounds. Do you think that's going to be enough going in towards their CT side?
I think that they're going to struggle against Liquid's T side. But this pistol round's really going to determine a lot. They need this pistol. They need to get up to nine rounds, and that'll establish the economy for them. If they can get a good economy, have XP3 get an op in his hands, and kind of, he likes to free form it. He likes to play mid. He likes to pick into A. That could really be beneficial for them on the CT side.
Well, they spot the mid aggression here. XP3 tapping away with the P2000 does manage to find the head of Kusta. Lands the shot and swings the man advantage early to Winter Fox. Now, interesting stack that they have at the A bomb site, because kind of unconventional to have three players playing over here. And that nade just wrecked Liquid. Now they're going to have to push in behind this. Desi goes down. They've got the Tech 9 going to work right now. Elige finds two. Nitro finds one. And just like I thought, that stack ends up not being as fruitful as one would have believed. And now XB3 trying to prevent the plant. He's going to get swept under the rug by Elige. Flowsick does manage to answer back. And nade? Oh, a little bit too far over Simple. I thought it was going to clean him up.
Yeah, I'm shocked. You called it. That nade ripped Liquid, but they pulled this round out. Or hopefully. Yeah, there it is.
Yeah. That nade did so much damage in AMA, and that was perfectly timed to drop three players down to sub 60, which is insane.
The real problem with that is that none of the players on Winter Fox were actually helping each other. So the nade rips Liquid. You have one at forklift, one in the side on the box, and one at quad. But every player from Winter Fox was traded or was killed without a trade. There was no peek from quad. The guy in sight died. The guy at quad could have gotten the trade. There was just, it wasn't coordinated very well. It was a nice stack. But if you don't work together in that situation, you're not going to be able to get those kills. And, you know, you also have to deal with Liquid's just talent. And they just outshot him when they were coming into the site.
Absolutely. So no investment from Winter Fox here. This is kind of interesting to see. They do go for two P250s and a 5.7, but it's no armor onto them, no nades to work with either. So this is a pretty clean non-buy round here from them. And trying to spot out over here at B is actually Winter Fox, who does spot out Simple over there by Toxic, but he has no idea what's coming in his wake right now. Oh, don't take the peek. Don't take the peek. Oh, he's taking the peek. 58 HP gets chipped down a little bit. Couple more players that are over there, but he still has only spotted one player that he knows of over at B. And now when the push comes in, it's just going to be a swarm of Liquid players onto this B bomb site. And here it comes. Nicely managed from Flowsick so far. Finds the opening pick. Spots out another one. They know that there's a couple of players. Looking for the second, but Elige, he's privy to it. Finds the headshot angle. Takes him down over by Generator. And now it's just going to be a brawl over here at B. All of the CTs rotating in, but they're not ready for this player event. There you go. Nitro is going to be able to shut down the flank. Yeah, so it should be clean.
But it's actually, Flowsick should have never gotten that kill, to be honest. They missed a molly. They tried to do a full molly, just, you know, eco execute into B. They missed the molly for rail. So Flowsick was able to stay on rail and had the headshot angle and got that first kill. Not that it's going to make a big difference. I don't even know what Kusta had, but he probably didn't buy much because he's going to be saving for the op. He gets the information, so it wasn't a big deal. But if they actually hit those mollies, there's no kills on that round. It was really clean.
So they only lose one member at the end of that. Kusta going onto the Tech 9 armor buy, full nade kit to go behind that. The ump still in the hands of Nitro and the MP7 for Hiko, but the other two are going to have the AKs, Simple and Liege. So they've got the upgraded firepower. And even it's kind of more of an investment into this round than they had last round from Winter Fox. They pick up a Desert Eagle on Anger, a couple of P250s to finish out the rest of them. And they go for the aggression over here towards A main. And nicely done. Kusta, oh, that was beautifully played. Playing the bait and switch with his teammate, just hunkering down behind that box. Once he actually got dinked, found that opening kill, was knocked down to 2 HP, and just hid, let his teammate with the long range AK clean up the other player that was over there. And Simple, we see spinning around and finding the final kill. So nothing for Winter Fox, goes right that round, and Liquid are going to double up 12-6.
Those are really two clean rounds by Liquid, which they need to establish the economy control. It allows them to buy full nades. And I don't know if that was a set play where you have Kusta go into A main with just a Tech 9, but it's a really smart play because he's not investing anything. So if they rush him and they kill him, at least he has that information. They had another player on stairs, which allowed to get those quick trade kills. Really, really nicely done by Liquid.
No, I like this. They saved the ump, they saved the MP7 going into this round, so they're going to play the economy game moving forward right now. Hiko picks up the AK, throws over the MP7 to Kusta, who was the nearly fallen comrade in the last round. But look at this, they're actually going for, what are they doing on Winter Fox's side? They're going to boost up on top of that. What is this? This is a weird little mid stack that they have going on here. Two players playing, one on top of the pipe and one on top of the little electrical outlet over there. And Lex is actually going to get caught out, but that might bait Simple into a push in mid, but intelligently, he actually just falls off from it. There's the boost over, so he spots that one now, too.
I don't even know how that's possible. Like, you know, you hear him jumping around. There should have been a call that he was in mid main, and he should have never gotten that kill. But
good trades, though, coming out from Liquid's side. Anger is able to find one. XP3, though, does deny the bomb plant for the time being. Gives his teammate time to rotate up through highway. Molotov comes out, XP3 finds a second onto a Liege, so again denies the bomb plant. Now the bomb is out in the open a little bit here. I don't know if XP3 has eyes on it, but Kusta in a tough spot over by A main, and XP3 has been given time to work his way up behind red box. So if Hiko goes for the bomb, he's gonna shoulder peek it out. They know that he's there, and there's the peek out. Desi does find Hiko, so the trades continue on, and Liquid should be able to get this round with 12 HP on Desi, but he's running all the way back around to flank out A main, so this could be a little bit of a kink in the think here. He could catch Kusta by surprise.
Yeah, it doesn't look like Kusta has even thought that he could be flanking, and this might catch him up. Oh, there it is.
Wow, nice shot from Desi, though. Going to clutch out the round for Winter Fox, and he gets the AWP out of it. He's going to go hunt for that real quick, because even though he doesn't have a kit, he's got plenty of time for the defuse. And Winter Fox is going to steal one away from Liquid here. And it looks like we have a little bit of a game crash going on here. Come on, DJ! Guys, yeah. The cameraman needs your energy real fast.
That round, it's actually fortunate. Desi was sitting on that, 12-10 HP. Kusta, it looked like last minute he thought, okay, maybe he's coming from A main, but Desi hits just a really nice shot. I still don't know. Liquid, this is a problem with a lot of the top teams. They tried to force the plant in the best spot, but there was no smoke down, so XP3 gets that first kill. Then they tried to plant in the same exact spot, and they kill the bomb planter again, and all of a sudden it's a 2v2 when it was a 4v2.
Yeah, a little bit little lackluster coordination there. Now XP3 in A main, he's going to get aggressive this time, but it's a 2-0 favoring Liquid to start off this round, and that's a big start to the round for them. Not only do they drop the AWP, but they've got the AWP in the hands of Kusta. He lays a leg shot out on the flow sick, and that nade almost cleans him up. 3 HP, somehow survives by the skin of his teeth. Molly to the back of quad, Molly to NBK. Hiko does finish off flow sick, and now it's going to be Lex to try to hold on for dear life, and he's not going to get very far in this round. So it's down to a 1v4, and this should be Liquid hard resetting Winter Fox right here.
A lot of damage done, but, you know, Anger has no idea that he's got some easy kills, but it's the best to save to here. Those two early picks were huge. I don't know how that Nate didn't get Flowstick. It was pretty close. He was already on 12, went to 3. Hiko opens the door, gets the easy pick, and it's just a cleanup. And they actually, you know, even though it was a 1v4, they actually waited for the smoke to land in the back of the site to plant the bomb this time, which was the smart thing to do.
Yeah, so simple on the hard hunt. Ooh, did he not? He didn't spot anger? Oh, my God. He's in the fence.
What? He's right on the street.
He's going to come up. There you go. All right.
Someone had to. Someone called that on radar. Someone called it because he wasn't even looking for that.
Yeah. You see him.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man. That would have been highlight.
That's actually a really tough round for them. Like, a beautiful. Two rounds ago, that 2v2, great round by Winter Fox, but it put him on a really bad economic situation. Liquid, you called it. They saved their SMGs, so they were in a great situation. Win this round, and now Winter Fox is looking like they're going to probably have to save twice unless they force next round.
They might end up forcing next round.
Well, yeah, it's going to be 14.
That's going to put Liquid on 14. So unless they want to play for the tie here and try to save 8 match points, that's going to be a really tough spot for him to be in. So I expect some form of investment, probably a couple of UMPs or something to go along with it. But Kusta and Nitro not having any of it this round. They find all three of the players that are holding in that mid corridor, and that is going to really open up the round for him. There's one more player over here by Z that's Flowstick, but he's only got a P2000. So the limited firepower for Winter Fox is their downfall in this round. Not able to find any traits, not able to find any picks, and this should be an easy 14th now for Liquid.
Yeah, it's only this only makes it worse for Winter Fox. They didn't have any economy. It would be nice to get a gun. Now they really have no chance of getting any guns. They're going to go into the next round with no money. You know, like you said, they're going to have to force. Yeah, you can't go for 15 when you only have 7. So it's not looking good for Winter Fox right now.
Not at all. And this is what you kind of said, you kind of hinted at, was Liquid's terrorist side on this map. You know, their CT for a while has looked a little bit lackluster in a couple of different times that we've seen them on cache. And this is one of the maps that we've notoriously kind of hyped up as Liquid's one of their strongest, if not their strongest map. You know, Nitro's playground, so to speak. Let him go get those entries on the terrorist side. This time around, it's Elysian Simple that are doing work. Not that Nitro's underperforming because he's at 18-7 right now, but 23 kills for Elise, 23 kills for Simple. Hiko down at 14, but he's got 5 assists. And then you've got Kusta at the bottom with 9 kills, but he's still up there in the mix as far as where the frag counter is for the Winter Fox side. And here's that investment that we were talking about. Look at the limited utility for Winter Fox. Now the push comes in. They don't clear out the pit. They're going to push a second player behind this. And Flowstick locking it down, gets the dink out as well. So Nitro only able to get a one and done. And that's going to leave Desi over here with XB3 at the B bomb site and bomb control as well. And another dink goes out. So really interesting kind of debacle that Liquid has found themselves in this round. They walk directly into that pit stack.
I'm not sure what Liquid was doing there. You know that they're on low money. They jump through a smoke, which just... Oh, wow. Kusta's turning... Oh, wow.
Really close. Going to turn it around, yeah.
I thought so, too. like I was saying, I just don't know what Liquid was doing there. You know, if anyone says they're on low money, they have no nades, let's take this slow, make them use what utility they have. You saw they had only had Famuses, you know... There was no reason to jump through a smoke and give 2 free kills to Winter Fox. I just don't see that play. Yeah, you have a big lead, but you don't want to let them get back into this. You don't want to give XB a 3-8 free off. Like, what are you doing? So,
and that's the big thing. I mean, I can only imagine Moses facepalming on that one because it's like you said, you know that they were on a really tight eco round last round, especially after a reset on a round win from them that came down to... one player alive. I mean, it was a 4v, it was a 1-on-1 that was clutched out by Desi in that round. Yeah. And then after that, they get a hard reset. So after investing into 4 guns and draining your account, you have 4 rebuys, you lose everything. That's as hard of a reset as you can possibly go into.
Yeah, so, and the big thing about that is that Liquid's fortunate that Kusta got those last 2 kills because it actually forced Winter Fox to buy up again. So they're really low here as well. And if they lose this round, they're in the same situation. But you have XB3 who gets an early pick on Simple. And they right now they have the advantage. You know, it's a good situation for them.
Well, yeah, I agree. I would have liked to have seen them go a little bit slower in the last round because you got to assume that they're going to be buying and not playing for the ties. So you got to think that they might be a little bit weak as far as the economy. And wait out the smokes. They're not going to have the flashes and the nades to soften you up as you try to hit in towards the bomb sites. So Interesting to say the least, but again, I mean, it's only a man disadvantage. They're not checking under boost right yet. Now they spot out Lex, and he's going to go down. So they even things up, and there's nobody in mid to help trade out with Lex. So out in no man's land, out underneath a boost by mid main, and he goes down for free. And now the hit comes in towards the B-bomb site. Kusta opens up, finds Desi, one more to beat. Flowsick goes down, no trade available, and now it's been swung back into a 2v4. B3 burning alive up top, trying to lay a shot out in towards the checkered side. I think he might have actually just walled Kusta down to 40 with that no scope, but again, just a really difficult situation for Winter Fox to be in. They had the man advantage, and they've squandered it going into the late stages of this round. Yeah, and now they're saving.
It's the save here. It's the right play. You really have no chance. I think Liquid's gonna definitely hunt them here, but we'll see what happens. They're gonna check CT spawn.
We're going to send one player over here. Anger's got an interesting angle here. If the shot comes out from Hiko, he should be able to peek out and trade this instantly. Or he's just going to sit back and hide, and Hiko's going to get really close on this. And now they're going to have the opportunity to double peek, so they're not going to take any guns into the next round. That, again, is another extremely difficult reset, and you can see they've got no money to work with, so it's going to be pistol armor into this round. They can't even buy up SMGs unless Desi picks up an ump.
Yeah, the last round was really, really well played by Liquid. They go from one bad round to a good round. Kusta was very patient. Desi peeked early, got some information, died, but you had Flowsick sitting in a corner just waiting to get that trade and maybe possibly a second kill. Desi re-peeked. Kusta was just waiting for him the whole time, got the easy pick, and they went to the site and got the trade. So, Winter Fox is on the last buy of the half or the game, and it doesn't look good for them.
Yeah, very limited. They've got Amali and a smoke on Desi, a flash on Flowsick, armor and pistols. Not really a whole lot to work with here. And again, this is where we see Liquid actually taking it slow. So they're listening to what we were saying before. And, there's no reason to speed things up into a round like this. You don't want to get into a close range battle with these overpowered pistols. And you can see they're actually going to filter in towards that A bomb site, which is where they can take a little bit more of a range duel. So Hiko over by Squeaky is going to be able to spot out one by Forklift. And little do they know there's actually two players over here by Forklift. But the smokes come out, the mollies go out. And Anger does hit a nice shot there with the Desert Eagle, a party gift, if you will, because he should be going down here soon. And he does. Lex is going to be over there as well, trying to make something happen. But the AWP comes in, and it gets shut down completely. So 16-8 is going to be the scoreline for the first matchup of the evening. Liquid take it over Winter Fox. Any last thoughts on that match?
Well, I think that we, early on, Winter Fox had some control, and we called that there was going to be a deciding round on that fourth round on CT side, and Liquid needed to make an adjustment. Winning that round was huge. The adjustment they made was getting the two CT rounds, or excuse me, two ops on CT. It just gives them a lot of information. On T side, you said it earlier, Liquid, it's their playground on cash. I would agree with you. Like, I don't necessarily think that they have the deepest of playbooks, but on cash, when you have the talent they have, they can get away with a lot more. It allows them to be more of a free-flowing team. I think that's what Hiko wants to do. I know that's what Simple wants to do. Kusta is dynamic in the sense that he can be free-flowing with the AWP, or you can set him in positions and he's just going to be a turret and dominate. So he didn't have a great match, but he didn't have to have a good match. He got the information that they needed. Liquid, bottom line, Liquid made the adjustments they made, and as soon as they got rolling, it was pretty much over.
All right, so that's going to actually wrap up match number one. Coming up here very shortly is going to be Overpass between Liquid and Winter Fox. And then to follow that up, guys, we've got a doubleheader between CLG and LG. And then we've got a doubleheader between Selfless and Splice. The CLG-LG matchups are going to be on Cobblestone and Overpass, so you guys know. I see Inferno for the Selfless Gaming matchup, and then that's going to follow up with Cash. So that's going to be the evening for tonight, guys, so make sure that you're staying tuned. I'm not sure if we're switching over to the main ESL channel just yet, as the SKNIP matchup is finishing up here very, very soon, so we'll keep you guys posted as far as that's concerned, but stay put, because Overpass between Liquid and Winter Fox is coming up next, guys. We'll be right back.
ESL Pro League is brought to you in part